A great day to all who hear me. I'm again here. Today I'll be talking to you regarding the character building up of our students, of our children. Every parent wants to hear good things about their children. It is very painful if a parent has to hear bad things about their children. I mean to say about the character, the behavior of children. No child is born with a character. Character has to be built in every child. The question is, who will build character in a child? I will hold two parties responsible for building character in a child. Ek parents and dusra teachers. Parents or teachers dono milke ek bachche ke andar character instill karta hai. Let me talk about the parental background, how a parent has to behave with a child, with a growing child, so that you can mold a special character in your child exactly as you want your child to be behaving. First of all, what are the character aspects people find fault of? Some children are very quarrelsome. Some children are argumentative. Some children are always with disobedience. Sunte nahi, kisi ke bhi baat mante nahi hai. Aur indiscipline. Ek kuch cheez baar baar bachcho ke saath deal karte time mein ek question mark ban jata hai. Quarrelsome behavior. Actually, kaha se bachche ka quarrelsome behavior, bachche kaha se adopt karta hai? From where they adopt quarrelsome behavior? It is from the immediate surrounding, that is the family. Parents have to take utmost care in front of their child when they talk or quarrel. It is a very common scene in Indian families, differences of opinion between parents. Papa, mummy, bachcho ke samne ladai karte hain. Bachche aake school mein bolte hain, aaj upset hoon. I'm not able to do anything. Kal mummy papa ke beech mein bahut zor se ladai ho gaya. They were fighting and I'm disturbed. And really I feel it that the children come, they don't pay attention. Parents don't even think that yes, hamara jo chote chote quarrel bachche ke samne karta hai aur uske dil mein wo kya feeling aate hai. The child cannot express, he becomes more irritable. He understands, agar papa mummy ke saath gusse se baat kar sakte hai to main kyon nahi baat kar sakte. The same thing, agar mummy papa ke saath agar pyar se nahi rehte hamesha jhagda kar rahe to main bhi kar sakte is cheez. Agar vice versa, opposite, if you think about it, if the parents have got very healthy relationship, they, though they have differences of opinion, differences of opinion piche reh jate, bachche ke samne nahi leke aate, to o situation mein bachche ke andar ek feeling rehta hai, yes, my parents are always in happy mood, they are happy go lucky friends, so whatever they say together, whatever they tell me, I will have to listen to their things because my parents are always good to each other. So being good to one another at home, the husband and wife, that is an important essential for a child to grow up as a very very understanding child. He doesn't get any glimpses of quarrels or misunderstandings everywhere. He understands, yes, I have to be polite, I have to be understanding. So this is the parents have to take care of it. Second thing, at home not only husband wife quarrel karte or disagreement karta hai, even in-laws ke beech mein, mother-in-law is shouting at the daughter-in-law, the child listens to it, he or she develops an anger towards the grandparents. So ek bachcha ghar mein hai to aapko ye sab चीज के ऊपर ध्यान रखना पड़ता है. हम क्या बात कर रहे घर पे, हम कैसा बिहेवियर कर रहे, वो बच्चे के ऊपर भी रिफ्लेक्ट हो सकते हैं. देन क्रिटिसाइजिंग अबाउट नेबर्स, इट हैपेंस. that it's a common scenario when people at home, family members, एक साथ बैठते हैं तो बच्चे के सामने बड़ा दूसरों का बड़ा बुराई बुराई बताते हैं, मतलब they criticize one another. वो बच्चे सुनता है. That is the way the child picks up. The child listens to criticism of the neighbors through his parents' mouth. The child feels, even I can do that. Yes, and the child goes on doing the same thing. There, the character, when the child does it, people say that, yes, the child is a wrong child. From where is he picking it? We elders are giving him the lessons of gossip and criticism. Third thing is comparison. Please don't compare your children with your neighbor's children. Your child is very precious. He is born with his own skills, his own understandings, and he is given the fertility of family background. अगर family members उसके अंदर अच्छे संस्कार दिया, वो बच्चा अच्छा बच्चा बनके आगे बढ़ेगा. So उसको comparison की जरूरत नहीं है. देखिए अगर next neighbor के बच्चे कितना अच्छा mark उसको मिलता है. He speaks very well. He speaks. He is very confident. He goes for different competitions. तू क्यों नहीं कर रहे? ये comparison बिल्कुल नहीं करना है बच्चे के साथ. Because you will have to train your child. उसके अंदर भी बहुत सारे चीज है, हमें उसको निकालना है. Rather than comparing with your neighbor's child, it makes your child upset and he feels that I am useless. Day by day, if the comparison is there, the child feels useless. Of course, examples are necessary. Role models are necessary. At the same time, you will have to tell the child, yes, the neighbor's child has got these qualities. Perhaps you have some other quality in you. If you try hard, I don't want you to become just like the neighbor's son, but I want you to be brushing up your skills. So that is called as encouragement. Comparison and encouragement are two different things, but we take it different. We misunderstand comparison and forcing the children. So please do not force your child to be like somebody else. Encourage the potential within him. Ask the child to compete with himself. दूसरे के साथ तुलना मत कीजिएगा. बच्चे को बोलना खुद की skills को compete करने के लिए. खुद को skill के अंदर खुद के अंदर बहुत सारे skills रहेंगे. वो skills को brush up करो. उसके साथ compete करने के लिए. Rather than competing with others. Now engaging the child in friendly talks. Last session also I have told you, being friendly with a child meaning sharing all the aspects with the children. Especially a growing child will have lots of anticipations, worries. He will be worried about his friends. Maybe a boy will have an attraction towards a girl, a girl will have an attraction towards a boy, and these things are hidden or suppressed inside. It may burst out like a wildfire. It is better the parents have to sit with the child and talk to him or her about his or her friends, be it a girlfriend or a boyfriend. If it is a girlfriend, a boy liking a girl, it is not a crime. In fact, if the parents are giving the right support to the child, the child understands the good things of opposite sex, opposite male chief. Boys will understand the qualities of girls and girls understanding the qualities of boys. There should not be anything hiding or secret things between the parents and the child. The child will not tell, but the parents have to encourage the child to speak about what is happening with his friends circle. Sometimes his friends can be bullying. The child has to report to the parents. The child will not report unless the parents ask, understand, dig out that, not directly but indirectly, sitting with the child, ask about all the good and bad aspects of his friendship. So discussion with the child is the most required thing right now, rather than asking him to sit and study or asking about how he has done it, why you have not done it, such type of comparisons. Instead of, have a friendly discussion with your child. I think your child is going to be the most wonderful child if both the parents together take the decision regarding the child. If mother scolds a child, please, the father has to just keep quiet. He or she should not, in between, he should not interfere. In the same case, if father is scolding the child, the mother should not scold the father right in front of the child. The child should understand, about to me, my parents have the same opinion. My growing up is done by my family members. The child indirectly begin to love the family. As I said earlier, loving one another is the basis of any growth in the society. And I am in touch with Aapdu Junagadh. Aapdu Junagadh has given me the opportunity to speak every week. Now this is the second session I am doing with you, and I am very, very grateful to Aapdu Junagadh, and all the best to Aapdu Junagadh for such lovely sessions with all the people. Thank you, and have a wonderful weekend.